The parts of a 35mm single lens reflex camera. We'll begin with the lens. The lens is responsible for focusing and shaping the light as it enters the camera. I'm going to remove the lens so that you can see the different aspects of the lens. Here's the focus ring. Here is the aperture ring. The aperture is the second major part of a camera. It is that little diaphragm that you see inside here that can close down, open up, restrict the amount of light that passes through, or allow a greater intensity of light to pass through during exposure. And that is controlled by the ring on the side, as is the actual focus of the lens. This lens contains 3 or 4 separate pieces of glass on the inside to help correct for aberration, for how different wavelengths of light focus at slightly different distances. So there we have the lens and the aperture. The next major part of the camera to look at is the shutter. Now the shutter is contained inside the camera. You can't really see it from the front and you can't readily see it from the back. If I pull up on this knob on the side, see it's spring-loaded, and as I pull up a little further and engage the spring, it will undo the lock that allows the back to open. This section right here is the shutter. Now I'm going to set this so that you'll be able to readily see the shutter open and close. Wind the camera, press the release. You'll see the shutter open and then close. We are set for a 1/2 second exposure. Shutter opens for 1/2 second and closes. You'll notice when the shutter opens, we lose the light in the viewfinder. As the shutter opens, the viewfinder looks black. And that's because on the front, when the shutter engages, this mirror, which channels the light from the lens up into the top prism and then out the back, the mirror flips up out of the way and then reseats itself. So the mirror flips up, shutter's open, shutter closes, mirror drops back into place. So while that mirror is up, don't ever do this, please. While that mirror is up, the light cannot get through the viewfinder. Mirror drops down, viewfinder is open again. So the mirror has to flip up out of the way for the light to pass through while the shutter is open. And expose the film. Now, the shutter itself, if I bring this a little closer, this shutter is made out of really thin, almost a foil. It's metal, and there are 2 control arms here. Now, when I wind this camera to the next shot, you're going to see this shutter, you'll see this shutter curtain actually moves up, and behind it is a second curtain. When I engage the shutter, first curtain opens, drops down, and then this curtain drops from the top down. As I wind the camera, the bottom curtain moves back up, top curtain moves out of the way. Now you notice this has a slight bit of damage to it right here. And if this were on the other curtain, it might be enough to really jam the shutter. You can see this is, it's a really thin foil. You really don't ever want to put any pressure at all. Don't ever try to clean it. And that's controlled by the shutter speed dial. Set this on a 60th of a second. You see it moves pretty fast, 1/60th of a second. Almost can't see it open and close. If I take this up to its fastest speed, 1/1000th of a second, you'll hear it and you'll see the mirror move and block the viewfinder, but you won't really see the shutter change, but you won't be able to see it open and close. It's just, it opens and closes too quickly. Those are the major parts of 35 millimeter single lens reflex camera. There are many other functions that you'll need to be aware of on a 35 millimeter camera, as we spoke of earlier. This dial on the barrel of the lens will control the focus. You can see the front element move forward and back. And behind it, closest to the body, is the aperture ring. This controls the size of the aperture. The small number, f1.8, will give us that large opening. 22 will give us the small opening. Let me show. So with the aperture ring set on 22, get this so you can actually see the hole, very small. As we open this up towards 1/8, aperture ring gets to 1.8. Aperture is at its largest value, 22 at its smallest value. You'll notice it never actually closes. It's always open. It always allows some light to pass through. And that's because it's the job of the shutter to allow or not allow light to pass through and expose the film. The shutter opens, the shutter closes. The shutter is controlled by the shutter speed dial. It controls the amount of time that the shutter is open. Speed is kind of a misnomer here. If I have this set on 1, it is a 1 second exposure. At 2 is 1/2 a second. 4, 1/4 of a second. 8 is 1/8. And through 1/15th, 1/30th, 60, 1/25th, 1/250th, 1/500th, 1/1000th, which we know too fast to see. We also have this B, which is referred to as the bulb setting. And that's for time exposures or long exposures. With the camera set on B, Press the shutter release. Shutter opens, and it will stay open as long as my finger is on that release. When I remove my finger, shutter closes. Open, closed. This dial controls the length of time the shutter is open. The button in the middle is the shutter release. That's what engages the shutter. This handleless arm is the film advance lever. As I turn this, you'll see the wheels will turn and film moves from the film can across the back, gets picked up on this spool, and winds from one side to the other with each index of the film advance. The plate here is film pressure plate. When you push that down, that pushes the film nice and flat against the film rails. Here's our film counter. As we wind through here, take our shots, you'll see the number will increase. 3, 4, 5, as we move through. When we're at the end of the film, the film is all on this side of the camera, we need to get it back all the way to this side, and we do that by flipping this little lever out and winding in the direction of the arrow, and that will wind our film back in. The problem is that the way the gearing is set up in this camera, it will only move the film forward. It'll only allow the film to move forward one shot at a time. So in order to release the gears, put them in neutral so that we can rewind the film, on the bottom of this camera, little button here, I push this button in, click. And now all the gears inside are in neutral. So they'll spin back and they'll spin forward. They'll go either way now. As soon as I advance this, that button will pop out and this is not going to move at all. Push the button in, puts this in neutral, and now this will rotate forward and back. So I can flip the lever out. Gears are in neutral, rewind my film. On this side of the camera, you see the ASA or ISO dial. And the ASA, the ISO dial, let me turn this so you can see it a little better. Get it up here a little bit better. Is a measure of the sensitivity of the film to light. So film that is not sensitive to light has an ISO value 25, 50, 100. Film that is more sensitive will be 400, 800, 1600, up to 3200. And that's just an indication of how sensitive the film is to the amount of light that's passing through the camera and striking the film. What this dial does is set the meter inside the camera so that it's calibrated with the film, so that the film is recording the correct amount of light every time you made an exposure. If you had film with an ISO of 400 and you had your meter calibrated to 200, then your meter would be indicating an exposure value twice what the film actually needed, and you would end up with overexposed film. So you calibrate the meter with the ISO of the film. Now this particular roll of film is Ilford HP4. It has an ISO of 125. Every camera is a little bit different. This one has an outer ring. You pull up on the ring and it releases. So I can set this at 125. And now the meter in this camera is calibrated for this particular roll of film. You won't have to mess with this at all. If you purchase 400 speed film, 400 ISO film, and you'll set this the ISO at 400 and you'll never have to reset it. It's a self timer on this camera. If I wind this and I pull the timer up, the timer will count down. This button allows my lens to attach and unattach. It's called a bayonet mount. Turn it a quarter of a turn. You'll hear it click into place to take it out. Push this button in. Turn it. Release the lens. It's okay to release the lens with film in the camera. Put this on. Turn. And click. We're going to put film into the camera. So I pull up on the release knob, boop, opens the back. I place the film can in the back of the camera. Push the lever all the way down so that it drops into place. That holds this canister in place. Be really careful. I've got my fingers near the shutter. It's not a good thing. I'm going to pull the film across a little further than I have to. And I'm going to place the film in the take-up spool. Click the shutter. Turn that and, oh, it popped out. This is one of the big dangers of loading a roll of film, making sure that it's properly on the take-up spool. Wind it. Look at the film has gone around. Come back up. Click the shutter and wind it a second time. Now it's going across this spool here and is wrapped around the take-up spool, so I know it's kind of grabbed on itself and it's in good shape. I'll close the back. And now I can wind the camera, take photographs. So I go through my roll of film, and by doing it this way, I'm not exposing the film at all. Go through my roll of film. When I get to the end, I want to rewind the film. Flip the lever out, and it does not want to turn. The reason it does not want to turn, because I haven't released the gears. Push the clutch in, turn the knob. Hey, look at that. The film is unwinding. Now I heard it pop off the spool, so I'm going to stop. I'm going to open the back. And there's my roll of film returned to its original position. Now that's the way this camera works. Other cameras work differently. And so you have to know your camera. If you have a more modern version, an autofocus camera, it is likely also auto-load and auto-unload, which means you would just drop your film in the back like so, close the back, and the camera would automatically wind the film and get it hooked up. And when you get to the end of the roll of film, the camera will automatically rewind the film back into the can. So you have to know what your camera will do. I think I got everything here. Battery compartment. Most of the time it's on the bottom. Occasionally it'll be up on the front here. But other than that, those are the basic parts of a 35 millimeter single lens reflex camera. Thank you.